So, welcome to Mrs. Diva's page. You know, it is an initiative by Aastha Jain, and she's a superb business coach, and she's helping a lot of entrepreneurs, homemakers, mothers to become financially independent. And she's a really, really nice and warm lady, and it's a pleasure to connect with her and all of you as well. So, this is Nidhi Gupta. I'm the founder of Parent Time by Nidhi Gupta. And I'm a parenting and nutrition coach, and I'm also certified in child psychology and mental health. Hi Munaz. Hello Subodh. Yeah, so I hope you all are taking all the necessary precautions and staying at home. Yeah, so make sure you're not eating too much, huh? So take care of your health as well as your mental health as well. Okay. So today's topic, as you all know, is about kids' nutrition and mental health, and also about their eating habits. So we'll start with the topic. So I chose this topic because this is the topic we get the maximum queries about at parent time, and parents are mostly worried about how much their children are eating. They are preferring junk food over healthy food, and they're just generally worried about their eating habits, because no parent is ever satisfied with how much their child is eating and what their child is eating. So it's all right. It's a very, very common problem, and all the parents are dealing with it, and it's not that it's not workable. So I'll tell you some simple strategies that will help you through your journey, and it will help you ease your struggle a bit. Okay. So I'll start with the first point, which is start early. So what do I mean by start early? So what I mean to say here is, to inculcate healthy eating habits, you need to start as early as possible. How early do you start? You start as soon as your child starts eating solids. So as soon as your child turns 8 months, when he starts eating proper solids, you start giving them healthy foods like blanched broccoli, you give them blanched carrot, you give them fruits. They may not eat it, they may not like it, but your job is to offer healthy food to them from time to time. If they don't like it, they will not eat it. If they like it, they will eat it. So, first thing, start early. You need to do your bit and leave it up to the child whether he plays with it or he eats it. Let the child decide what he wants to do with that food. Also, I want to stress here that children are the pickiest. You know, they turn into fussy eaters from the age of 2 to 4. 2 to 4 is a very, very crucial age where you can inculcate healthy habits, and it will, you know, stay with them for their lifetime. So, but don't worry, if your child has already crossed this age, it's okay. We can still work on it. So, the next point is that you need to focus on what your child is eating rather than how much your child is eating. So it's a common thing with parents, you know, we stress about how much the child is eating, whether he is finishing the full plate or not, or you know, aaj kitne meals khaye. So we don't need to really bother about that. See, as I said earlier, our job is to offer them healthy foods at all times, and how much they eat is their decision. So of course, if the child is not eating even a bite, that's the point of worry. But if he's trying even little bit in a meal, it's okay. You can compensate this over the next meal. So don't stress about how much the child is eating. Just keep offering healthy foods, and just make sure that healthy food habits are developing. Then next point is, don't force. So since we have this, stress about finishing the plate and cleaning the plate, don't waste food. It's right that we don't waste food, but when we are building habits, we need to compromise somewhere. So if the child is trying to eat on his own, it's okay, just leave them alone and let them eat whatever. Don't ever force them to finish their food. So what happens if you force? When you force the children, they develop a negative relationship with the food. It's important for you as a parent to help them develop a happy relationship with the food. So I have to like my food to be able to finish it. So, and the same goes with the child. If he doesn't like the plate, if he doesn't like the food on the plate, he's not going to eat it. So forcing will never help. you have to encourage the child to eat the food. Then the next thing is, if you really want the child to finish the plate, give them small portions. Give them what they can finish, not what you want them to finish. So, and you need to increase the quantity gradually. What happens, see what we do as a parent, we think ki, you know, jitna khale acha hai. So, but that really doesn't work. We don't know how much their appetite is. We'll get to know this over a period of time. So for example, if your child is eating one roti, what you need to do is, you need to serve one roti and a small more, you know, a quarter roti more. So the day you see that child has started finishing that quarter also, along with the one roti, you start giving them one and a half. What parents usually do is, they give them two rotis, ki chalo ek to khata hi hai, ab hum do khilayenge. So it doesn't happen like that. The child's appetite reduces further. You know, child stops eating that one roti also. And then parents complain ki pehle to kha leta tha, ab nahi khata. So we need to increase the quantities gradually. Are you with me? Give me a thumbs up if you're with me already. Okay. So the next point is that do not distract them when they are eating food. I have seen that, you know, parents are feeding their children while they are playing, while they're in the car, or even during TV. So what happens when the child is not eating? We as parents, you know, we think ki chalo distract karke khila dete hain. One thing will be ki kuch to kha lega. Second, then our job is done, right? So in order to make the child eat at least something, we distract them. And yeah, I'm reading all the comments. Yeah, so what we do, we distract them in order to make them eat something. You know, I have also done this at a point of time when my son was not eating anything at all. I, you know, started those nursery rhymes and started feeding him like that. No, it just works opposite. And why is it important? You know, the child has to eat consciously when he is eating. He has his brain has to be aligned with the food. He has to know what he is eating. He has to know how much he is eating. Only then those signals reach the brain, and then the brain gives you a signal back that you're full, or, you know, I'm liking the food, that this is something I like. So, and when they are full, they'll tell you that mama please stop, or papa please stop. So this is the point where you really need to stop, right? Nobody likes force feeding. So even when we go to a relative's place, you know how annoying it is when they say ek aur khalo, ek aur khalo. We as adults also don't like it. So never force your children, and also make sure they are consciously eating their food, sitting at one place, whatever their you know, feeding equipment is, or their high chair or dining table with everyone. Make sure that they are focusing on their food nicely. Only then the food is going to be digested and the brain is going to get proper signals. And then now I'm going to share with you the most important point which I have developed myself, and you will not find it anywhere. If you understand and follow this point, I think 90% of your problem will be solved. So here it is. You need to understand the 3 T's of feeding a child. What are these 3 T's? T is for taste, T is for texture, and T is for tone. Now this is a whole cycle. You understand who all is involved in feeding a child. One is your child, who is the most important. Second is the food, you know, and then third is the caregiver or the mother or whoever is feeding the child. So these three are basically the important components of the feeding cycle. So it's a cycle. So now I'll explain the 3 T's to you. The first T, which I talked about, is taste. So you need to understand, this is basically about your child, not about you. So you need to understand the taste preferences of your child. Some children like sweet food, some children like sour, some children like salty food. You really need to understand and figure out what your child likes, and you need to, you know, prepare the meals and plan the meals accordingly. So, and it's not necessary that if he likes all sweet, you give them a plate full of sweet food. No, you have to ensure that what the child likes is also there in the plate in the balanced proportion. So if a child likes too much of salty, it does not mean that you give him all, you know, salty things. There has to be some salad also in the plate. There has to be some, you know, a curd without salt. You can balance it. So, but you need to ensure that the taste and flavors are according to the child's preferences. Now, how will you understand what the child likes? Now, you will not understand this in one day. You will understand it over a period of time. You need to observe your child. You need to understand all his meal patterns. And then over a period of 7 days or 10 days, you will realize, okay, so this is what he likes. Now, what happens in this case, you know, at the end of 10 days, we understand that, okay, he likes pasta. So what we do, we go to YouTube, we ask our friends and we, you know, learn all the varieties of pasta. And every day we start feeding pasta. Now what happens? The child stops eating pasta, right? And then we complain that itna mehnat kiya, I did everything for this child and now he has stopped eating. Now why this happens? Too much of anything is not good. You need to plan the meals according to it. Doesn't mean that you give him the same food every day. Do not allow the same food in every meal or every day, because there's also physiological reason behind it. If you give the same food every day, it will also lead to nutritional deficiencies. So the food has to be a variety of food in a plate. Yeah. So also, please also understand the taste. Once it is established, it can change also. So one month he might like savory food, the other month he might like sweet food. So keep watching those signals when he stops eating something, right? So we always complain ki pehle khata tha, ab nahi khata. Taste change ho gaya. Right, preferences change ho gayi, or maybe the child is bored because maybe you're serving it too much, right? So taste is one important thing that you need to take care about. Second, which is the texture, which is mostly concerns the food, which is the second component in our feeding cycle. The texture of the food, it's about how the food is cooked, it's about how it appears and how it is served in a plate. So we all invest in those, you know, cookie cutters, shapes and everything. This is good to, you know, introduce the food to a child, and the child will start accepting the plate and he will, you know, more inclined to try that food in the plate. So this is a good strategy to do, but also you need to understand whether the child likes crispy food, soft food, you know, crunchy food, or he likes pulpy kind of food, or very semi-solid kind of food. Now again, once you've understood the preference of your child, you don't need to make the entire meal like that. Make sure that in the plate you put some elements of his preference. Cook some food. Suppose he likes crispy and fried, so there is no harm in giving him a small nugget or cheese ball or something healthy which is crispy, crunchy, fried, a small portion on his plate. He'll be so happy to see his plate and he's more likely to finish the food or whatever he wants to eat in his plate, right? So texture is something that is very important. Again, also again, it might change, so you need to, you know, keep watching for those signals when you need to change your cooking strategies and cooking methods, right? So are you with me? Yeah. Thank you everyone. Okay, so the next component here which concerns the mother or the caregiver or whoever is feeding the child is the tone. Yes, the most important factor, the tone of the mother or the caregiver who's serving or feeding the child. So tone is basically the whole environment around the child when he is eating, before he is eating and after he has eaten the food. You need to make meal times fun. The child should look forward to meal times. Now how do you do that? Basically, you know, talk to the child about it, say, wow, lunch time is here, let's enjoy food. But what we actually do, we consider feeding as just a task and we say, you know, pehle khana khalo, khana khake kuch bhi karna, play after you eat food. So it just, you know, becomes stressful. Make sure it is not stressful, because this stress transpires to your child as well. If you are stressed, the child will be stressed, and in no way you can ensure that he has healthy eating habits. you know, it's natural, you know, when the child doesn't eat properly, we tend to get frustrated. It's okay. But don't show it, you know, calm down. And at a point, if you think that you're getting too frustrated, allow someone else to feed the child for a while, you know, for 2-3 days, just calm down, take your time out and allow someone else to feed the child. It might just, you know, help setting up the tone right, because others usually are not so stressed about how much your child is eating. Mothers basically are more stressed about it. So tone is very important. So not just before the food, during the food, when you're feeding the child, you need to be happy. You need to make sure that the child is happy. You need to ensure that the child is enjoying the meal. Talk to him about different things. And of course, do not distract, but talk to him about different things. Talk to him about the food, about the taste, about what does he like in his plate, what does he not like. Engage him, you know, in a conversation that he likes. It also helps in building family bonding if you're eating together. Then after the meal, this is the tone after the child has finished. Now, no matter how much the child has finished, you will not get frustrated. Just make sure that you're smiling and appreciate the child for whatever he has eaten. You can always compensate during the next meal. But if the child is crying even a bit, please praise him. Say that, "I really appreciate that you tried that one piece of broccoli. It's very yummy." Also, don't say that vegetables are healthy. You know, we tend to do, cookies are yummy and green vegetables are healthy. Now the child is very sharp, okay? They understand that why is it not yummy? And actually, you know, these green vegetables are not so yummy. So basically, we need to cook them in a tastier way as per the preference of the child. So for example, I don't like lauki, okay? I've never eaten it because I think that it is not tasty. So no matter what, you cannot feed me lauki in any form. And this is built since my childhood. But at the same time, I love tinda, because my mother used to cook yummy tinda, and since childhood I love it. So basically these habits come from our childhood, and this is the time that you focus on your children's eating habit as well. So don't say vegetables are healthy, say everything is yummy. Yeah, it works. Okay, so then 3 T's. So we are done with the 3 T's. If you actually understood and if you're going to follow these 3 T's that I've just told you, trust me, 80% of your problem will be solved. 20%, we'll apply different points, but 80% your problems will be solved. So if you've understood the 3 T's and if you're with me, just type TTT on your screen and send it to me so that I know that you've understood all the 3 T's. So taste, texture and tone. Nice. Okay, so we've understood the cycle. Now we'll move on to the next points. The next point is that since... Awesome. You guys are amazing. Thank you. Okay, you can also keep on typing your queries. I'll take up the questions at the end. Okay. So we move on to the next point is you need to model the behavior that you want your child to exhibit. If you want to have a child who prefers healthy food over junk food, please do that yourself. Chupke khalo agar junk khana hai, don't do it in front of your child. And actually, you know, little bit of junk is okay. Allow them that so that they don't crave too much for it. So, you know, when you offer them variety also, when I spoke about variety, you can give them a little bit of junk. It's fine. It just makes them happy. But don't make a big deal about it. Okay, that I am giving you junk, so today, you know, it's done. It's okay. Little bit of junk is okay. It will, if they're eating healthy otherwise, little bit of junk will not do any harm to them. So you need to model the behavior. I'll just give you my example. My son, who's 4+, he loves to eat sprouts and fruits. It's his favorite. Sometimes he'll skip the entire meal and he'll just eat a bowl of sprouts. You know why? Because ever since he was born, I switched to healthy food and I eat sprouts and fruits on a daily basis. And trust me, I have never asked him to eat it. Never. So he sometimes I get annoyed also that, you know, you're skipping dinner and eating sprouts, but I'm happy, you know. So if you do it, your child will copy you. Remember, they may not hear you no matter how much you crave, no matter how much you explain to them, but they are always watching you. So even if they don't hear you, it's okay. They are watching you. So do what you want them to do, right? So also, since I talked about variety, I'll just explain it a little bit more with an example. So you need to offer variety. For example, if when you give tiffin to your child, prefer a compartment tiffin, you know, which has 3 or 4 compartments. So how I do is, I have a 4-compartment tiffin. What I do, one compartment is for fruits, one is for vegetables, one is for anything of his choice, anything. And then one is the main course, where, you know, we give the main course, the paratha, the puri, the pasta, whatever, the sandwiches, anything. So every night I sit with him and I ask him, okay, so which fruit you're going to have in your fruit compartment? So, and it's not that he'll tell any random thing. I'll give him choices. I'll give him 3 choices which I'll have in the fridge, that, okay, you want kiwi, apple or orange. What do you want? So he'll tell me what he wants. Then I ask him, okay, which vegetable you want? He loves cucumbers, so I'll give him a choice between cucumber or maybe some carrots or broccoli or cauliflower, whatever he likes. So out of 3-4, he'll choose one. And then the main course, I give him 2 options. Now, what are these options which are convenient for you? Okay, so for example, if I'm planning to make idli in the morning, I'll ask him, you want big, big moon-like idlis or you want tiny, tiny coin-like idlis? So, you know what it does to the child? They just feel happy that they are being asked and they feel empowered. Everyone likes to have their life in their control, even the children. So, if you allow them to choose, and if you allow them to decide what they're going to have in their tiffin, trust me, they are more likely to finish their tiffin. And now the 4th compartment, sometimes he asks, that is like a free thing, ask anything that you want. It's a small compartment. So sometimes I give a small piece of chocolate, a candy, or some chips, some nachos, whatever he likes. So it's okay. And I have set a rule that, you know, you have to finish out of 4, at least 3 completely. And trust me, mostly all 4 are empty. Sometimes he eats just 3, but most of the times I get an empty tiffin. So try that with your kids. Give them variety, empower them, let them decide, give them choices, negotiate with them. This really, really helps. Okay. So, and the next point is, everyone knows about it. During the lockdown, all the mothers are involving their children with them in the kitchen. It's a wonderful thing to do. So while after the lockdown is over, when you go out to buy vegetables, also take them along, ask them what would they like to buy. And when you're cooking, just tell them that, look, my child, I'm going to cook the vegetable you bought yesterday. So he'll be happy, okay, you know, I bought it and now mama is cooking it. And then ask him, would you like to see how it is being cooked? Would you like to help me? If they say yes, okay. If they say no, okay, no problem. But trust me, they're more likely to try things that they buy or something in which they get involved. So involve them in whatever way you can. Then the next point is, I already mentioned it, praise them. So whenever they try something new or whenever they, you know, complete their meal nicely, you got to praise them. So say that, I really appreciate how you tried a new thing today. I hope you like it. Don't say, wow, well done. No, don't overreact. Don't make it a big deal, you know. Even if they finished broccoli or spinach today, it's okay. I mean, don't make it a big deal. Even if you feel really happy inside your heart, don't show it too much, you know. It's okay. Broccoli khaye, aaj khaye, he may not eat it tomorrow again. So don't feel too happy. What you need to do is be firm, be warm, be gentle, and keep offering healthy foods at repeated intervals, right? But if the child shows negative behavior towards the food, just ignore it. So now this attention and ignoring are actually very important tools for all kind of behaviors of kids, not just food. If you want to understand them in detail, you can probably go to my YouTube channel. I've made detailed videos about these two topics. These are very, very important tools if you want to change any kind of behavior in your children. So go ahead and watch it if you want to understand how you should do it in an effective way. Yeah, so also you can also use little rewards. So I don't have my reward chart here, otherwise what I do is I usually make a small reward chart for my child, and I lay out the things that I want him to develop, you know, the new habits that I want him to develop. So what I do is I have a star, you know, small stickers, or I draw a smiley. When he does that particular behavior in that day, I give him that smiley or a sticker, and then at the end of the week we count how many smileys or stars he's earned, and then we give him little reward. You know, that could be anything, like extra stories or a new book or a new toy or maybe a chocolate sometimes, or 10 minutes of extra screen time sometimes. Yeah, so reward system is also very helpful. It motivates and encourages children, and it just brings that cute little smile on their face. It really, really works. Yeah, so now do we have any questions here? Okay, I do see some questions. I think I'll just take them up at the end. Just right. I like it how you all are really participating. Yeah. Okay. So these were the basic steps that you should follow while building healthy eating habits in your children. Now again, let's think of the extremes. What do you do if your child is not eating at all, is not trying? You've tried everything, you are, you know, giving him beautiful plates and making nice shapes, making rainbows, and still he's not trying. What do you do? So I'll give you some little pointers what you should do when the child is just not showing any interest in the food. These are some basic things I'll tell you. Okay, first thing is, what you need to do is set up a routine. We already have a routine set for us, but especially for children who don't eat at all, make a timetable that at this time you serve the breakfast, then the mid-morning meal, then you know, the lunch time, then milk time, whatever. So you have a set pattern. Now when you serve the food to your child, you tell the child that okay, it's meal time, let's have your food. Now you nicely, you know, eat your food, enjoy your meal, let the child see what you're doing with your food, and let him try. For example, he just eats a bite and he runs away. Okay, it happens, right? Or they just don't even eat that one bite and they run away. So what do you do? You go to your child politely and say that please eat your food. And this is the last time you're telling your child. Remember, you just tell your child twice. Third time, you're not going to tell your child. What you need to do is keep the food there for 20 minutes. Tell your child, I'm just waiting for you to eat your meal for the next 15 minutes. And after that, you're going to get your next meal after 2 hours. Okay, tell politely. The child does understand. Even a 1-year-old will understand what you're saying. So just make sure you're very warm and polite, and say that if you don't eat it, it's okay. The next meal you will get after 2 hours. So remember, just say it twice. If you say more than that, it becomes nagging. Nobody wants a nagging mother, okay? Don't nag. So just remind them twice, and then pick up that plate and remove it after 20 minutes. Just remove that plate. I know it sounds very harsh, but you need to take certain measures if you want to build up those healthy eating habits in your child. The child has to, you know, respect the food. So, you know, you just remove that plate, okay? Then after that, don't offer him alternate choices. Ki agar ye nahi khaya to main ye bana doon, ya, you know, you've not eaten roti, acha theek hai, I'll make some rice, aur aap pighal jate ho, you know, you're saying ki theek hai kuch to kha lo, chips hi kha lo, namkeen kha lo, sweet kha lo, laddu kha lo. No, if he is not eating at all, serve the next meal after 2 hours or whatever the scheduled time, and then remind the child that look, you had not eaten the meal before. I'm sure you're feeling irritated, frustrated, and your tummy is giving you some butterflies inside. So, you know, try and eat this meal. You'll feel more playful. You'll feel more energetic. It will help you play. You'll become a Superman, whatever. Okay? Try and encourage him to try the next meal. I'm sure the child will eat. And whatever tricky foods which the child does not eat at all, put a little portion of that also at that time in his plate. Because when they are extremely hungry, they are more likely to try those new foods. Okay? So this is very important that you don't give them alternatives, and you are firm that if he's not eating, it's okay. So I know it will take a lot of your heartbreak, and you'll panic also, you might cry in a corner also, but please do not give in, right? Also, what you need to do is repeat again. Yeah, so if the child does not eat lunch, give him the same food at dinner time. Okay, not the stale food, but the same thing. So if you had made dal rice, give him the dal rice again. So he knows that if he's not eaten, it does not mean he gets away with it. He will get it again. So the child will start thinking that I might eat it at lunch only, otherwise she's going to give me again at dinner. So be firm and consistent that since you had not eaten at lunch, you are going to finish it now. Not finish, but you're going to eat it now because this is what I have made, right? So repeat the same food. Also, again, I'm going to stress this point. If they show negative behavior or bad behavior towards food, if they just insult food, throw the food around, just ignore it. Do not attend to negative behavior. Do not pay attention to unnecessary tantrums. Just ignore it. So how to do that? It's a very, very long topic. You can, I'll again say that you go to my YouTube channel and watch that video. I've really explained that in detail. So I think that's about it. I've shared some tips with you. I hope these help you in some way or the other. And also I want to stress on a point that all children are different. They are unique. So do not compare your child with another and think that child, eats so much, my child doesn't eat anything, you know, his weight is so much, my child is very thin. Thin child is okay. As long as the child is, active and he's studying, he's playing, he's smiling, laughing, doing everything, it's okay. As long as the child is not severely underweight or severely overweight, okay? Child obesity is also very common nowadays. You don't need to worry. If your child is within that, weight range, which the doctor prescribes, that growth chart, please don't worry, moms. Some children eat more, some children eat less. Everyone's metabolism is different. Everyone's choices are different. You need to respect their decision and their choices and be firm and very, very consistent. You, as a mother or as a father, are the best judges for your children. If anyone says that your child is thin, you don't feed them well, or you do this, do that, it's okay. You know you're doing the best. So just follow these strategies and I'm sure you'll come out with flying colors. Remember the 3 T's, okay? Every morning just remind yourself of 3 T's and follow them consistently. If you still face issues, I'm always there. So you can just drop in a message at my Facebook page, Parent Time, or Instagram. You can follow me at Instagram. And even my YouTube channel, you can ping me anywhere. I'm always there to help parents. And whatever problems you have, you can just contact me. So I think we'll wind up here. Queries, I think I'll respond in the messages because it's difficult to... Okay. So I'll sign off for today. I hope to have another lovely session with all of you. Thank you for being with me. You were a lovely audience. Thank you, and thank you, Asta Jain, for this wonderful opportunity and platform. Thank you. So I'm signing off. Thank you. Bye.